please be seated.
America's White Table. The table honors the men and women who serve in America's armed forces. We cover a small table with a white cloth to honor a soldier's pure heart when he answers his country's call to duty. We place a lemon slice and grains of salt on a plate to show a captive soldier's bitter fate and tears of families waiting for loved ones to return. We push an empty chair to the table for the missing soldiers who are not here. And we lay a black napkin for the sorrow that's living. And turn over a glass for the meal that won't be eaten. We place a white candle for peace. And finally, a red rose and a vase tied with a red ribbon for the hope that all of us will return someday. You are not forgotten, so long as there is one left in whom your memory remains.
Please rise for our national anthem.
my pleasure to introduce the members of the Army. Please stand to be recognized. Please hold your applause until I announce all our Army guests. Matt Johnson, Matt Cronick, Steve Woodall, Gene Cantrell, James Goodyear, Bruce Gitlin, Ron Hankey, Lawrence Whitaker, Ken Whitaker, Herb State, Juan Tran, Wilbur Larson, Gene Crow, Sis Lightfoot, Bob Seagard, Daryl Ron, Jerry Ewing, Bob Roderson, Francis Ewing, and Don Kessler.
I therefore believe it is my duty to my country to love it, to support its constitution, to to obey his laws, to respect his life, and to defend it against all enemies, living in power of the nation. Clerk of the U.S. House of Representatives, 1917, accepted by the House of Representatives on behalf of the American people, the people of America, and the nation.
Veterans Day, Power's Day, soldier no must be God. 1921, an American soldier, saying no must be God, was buried on the Virginia hillside, overlooking the Potomac River and city of Washington. The Arlington National Cemetery will bury his site, the son of a World War I soldier, giving personification of dignity and reverence for American veterans. Similar ceremonies occurred in England and France, where an unknown soldier was buried in each nation's highest place of honor. In England, Westminster Abbey, in France, our patriot. These memorial gestures all took place on November 11th, the universal recognition of the celebrated ending of World War I hostilities at 11 a.m., November 11th, 1918, the 11th hour of the 12th day of the 11th month, the day of being known as Armistice Day.
Armistice Day officially received its name in America in 1962 through a congressional resolution. It became a national holiday, well deserved by similar congressional action. If idealistic hope had been realized that World War I was the war to end all wars, November 11th might still be called Armistice Day. But shortly after the holiday was proclaimed, World War II broke out here in the Shire of Union. 16.5 million Americans took part. 406,000 died. The families and friends of these dead long for their honor and memory. To honor veterans of all wars. In 1947, Raymond Weeks of Birmingham, Alabama organized a Veterans Day parade for that day on November 11th, Armistice Day, to honor all veterans. Later, United States Representative Edward H. Reese of Kansas proposed legislation changing Armistice Day to Veterans Day to honor all those that served in America in all wars.
After World War II, Armistice Day was still celebrated on November 11th. Throughout the year, 1983, people began calling it Veterans Day. This was a day in remembrance to the people of their town. Many people believe that it was deserved not only by World War I, World War II, and the Korean War as well. Congress decided to change the day to engage the honor those who served America in all wars. In 1954, President Dwight D. Eisenhower signed the bill proclaiming November 11th each year as Veterans Day. President Eisenhower called for Americans everywhere to rededicate themselves to the cause of peace.
Thank you. of religion. It is the veteran, not the reporter, who preserves our freedom of press. It is the veteran, not the poet, who preserves our freedom to speech.
It is the veteran, not the campus organizer, who preserves our freedom to assemble. It is the veteran, not the lawyer, who preserves our right to a fair trial. It is the veteran, not the politician, who preserves our right to a fair vote.
It is the veteran, salutes the American flag, who serves with honor on the American flag, whose confidence drapes with the American flag. When still more flags joined the United States, it was soon found that the flag would get to be an accurate shape if more and still more stripes were added. Therefore, on April 4, 1818, Congress passed a law that restored the design to the original 13 stripes and provided that a star be added to the blue field for each new state. And now, since 1959, when Hawaii added the last star, the flag as we know it today.
join me in singing the Pledge of Allegiance to the United States of America.
Thank you.
the Americans. Our honor and vengeance. Thank you.
Thank you. girl came to me in the middle of the week and said, "Hey, can you make some thank yous to honor our veterans and our community members that came to our program?" So we're going to pass an offering of thank you song. So I'm having to do that right now. And I think the message on the notes is the one that was in the song. Thank you, men and women, brave and strong. To those who serve so gallantly, we sing this grateful song. And I think one of the things that I hope you feel is our gratefulness to your service. We don't ask you to come here to bring back difficult memories, but those are parts of your lives. And those people that you know that we don't know, I hope you can say to them, thank you. I hope you can say to them, we appreciate what you have done for our country. And for the young people that are here today and are exposed to this, it's very important that you pay attention to this lesson. When we were out in the commons, we talked about a speaker that goes around the country saying, "Nobody told me." Well, I hope this experience tells you freedom's high price. You have to serve somebody. You have to serve your country. You have to serve your community. You have to serve your school. You have to do something to continue the tradition that we saw when the 185th did the flag presentation. This is a great country. We face many great challenges. I face some challenges. You people face challenges. You young students face challenges. How do you get overcome? The example is here for you. People that are willing to serve. People that are willing to put their life on the line for the belief in freedom, for the belief in democracy. For that, I thank you. I appreciate you spending some time with us. Our students, thank you. Thanks for coming. Thank you.